What's up, YouTube? So I'm coming on here to do another video where I probably am not gonna edit it. I'm probably just gonna upload it straight to YouTube because I want this to come out the way that it comes out. I don't wanna overthink it. I don't wanna over-edit it. I just wanna get this message to you. Also, I do wanna say my face is really tan and my hands are really white because my spray tan faded. So I wanna make that comment because I know the whole video you guys are gonna be like, what's happening to her? Anyway, so what happened was, an itch. I made an Instagram story like 5 minutes ago about a subject, and I kind of gave like a short version of like what I'm gonna give you guys now. And I said, if you guys want to see a whole video on this, let me know. And like immediately, like a dozen people were like, yes, please make a video about this. I need to watch this every week for the rest of my life. So here we are making this video. I'm gonna try to make it as short and sweet as I can, but I want to talk about the subject because it's very important to me. This is something that has radically changed my life and radically changed the way that I see food, see my body, and the way that I'm able to progress in like a fitness sense and in changing my physique. So I'm just gonna hop right in. Starting out, I guess I wanna share my old life and how it used to look and see like if maybe this is something you can relate to. But you know, so like let's dial back like 3 years, 2 or 3 years, 2015, 2016. I would just wake up every Monday morning like, hey, I had a really bad weekend. Like I went out to eat every day. Like I felt like I just overate a ton. So like, okay, it's Monday. I'm like, I'm gonna get back on track. I'm gonna be awesome. Like, let me open Instagram and see all my favorite fitspos looking sweet. Like, yes, I'm gonna look like that girl a week from today because I'm gonna stay on track super heckin' hard this week and nothing can stop me. So like, it's Monday, right? So we stay on track for the day. We micromanage our diet. Like, I'm gonna either eat really, really clean, or I'm tracking my macros, or I'm counting my calories. Like, I'm gonna be perfect. I might even undereat a little bit to make up for the weekend. I'm gonna go super hard on cardio. And like, so that's you, like Monday through Thursday. And you're like dieting really hard and whatever. And so then Friday hits, or maybe Saturday, and like, I'll just have a little treat today. Like, oh, maybe I'll just eat out a little. Or some weekends, you know, good and well, you're like, I'm eating whatever I want today. I had a hard week. I want to eat out. Like, I deserve this. Like, how am I supposed to say no to whatever, whatever? And so then you go out and you just eat like crap all weekend, either because there's events going on, or you were just like, oh, I just couldn't have this all week. So like, now I need this. I need a drink. I need a whole pizza. I need dessert after every meal. I need to stop at the grocery store on the way home and get more junk food for the house to eat while we watch TV, like whatever. And then that would be my whole weekend. It was just feeling like I had to get all the food that I wanted that I don't normally get during the week. And so then I'd wake up Monday morning again, like, oh my gosh, all the weight that I lost last week, I have regained and then some. And like, this was my life, was just like on a weekly basis, going super hard, like hardcore clean diet, no treats, making everything perfect. And then on the weekend, either like ruining my diet with overeating a ton, or feeling anxious all weekend and upset if I wasn't eating out. Like, I would be mad if I didn't let myself indulge, and I would just be bitter about it all weekend. So this was my life for forever, and I had so much anxiety around food. Every Sunday, Monday, I would just wallow in this awful feeling of like, I ruined my diet, I'm never gonna reach my goals, why am I like this, why can't I just stick to my diet and reach my goals? Like, I was so frustrated with myself, and I just couldn't get to where I wanted to be because I kept doing the same stupid cycle over and over. And so I see this in my clients, I see this in people on Instagram. Every Sunday and Monday, my inbox and my direct message inbox are flooded with either clients or people who follow me who are like, I ate really bad this weekend, I'm up 5 or 6 pounds, is that all fat? Like, is that normal? Like, or you know, I ate really bad this weekend, what do I do to get back on track? Like, I don't wanna undo my progress, blah, blah, blah. And there's just, oh, there's so much that I wanna say. I'm gonna try and do it in like an organized fashion, but first of all, I feel like what changed for me was choosing to take anxiety away from the situation. Choosing that when anxious thoughts came about food, like, oh man, you ate really bad this weekend, you're gonna gain weight and never reach your fitness goals, I would not let myself go through that. On Monday morning, I would tell myself, like, pretend the weekend didn't happen, pretend that that food doesn't have calories, like whatever I had to tell myself to like not feel bad or feel guilt about the food that I ate. That's the problem, is that feeling of anxiety and guilt that you're putting around food that does not need to be there. Like, Food, overeating food does not make you a bad person. It does not make you a criminal. Like, people like to throw terms around about eating disorders and you're disordered if you do this, if you do that. People like to call everything a binge. Like, people still to this day are like, oh, I binged on an extra handful of almonds over the weekend. And I'm like, that's not a binge. But anyway, the bottom line here being, take away the anxiety from food. Just decide, you know what? I'm never again gonna let myself feel guilty about the food that I eat. Even if I way overeat more than I know than I need to eat, I'm not gonna beat myself up about that because it's that pressure you put on yourself. It's that beating yourself up after a bad weekend. And excuse my verbiage, I don't mean to be contradicting myself by calling things like, oh, a bad weekend or eating bad food when it's not bad. I'm trying to catch myself with that stuff because in my mind, I've already decided no food is bad, overeating is not bad. None of these things are bad. The only thing that's really bad is beating yourself up over it, feeling anxious about it. Telling yourself that you're never gonna reach your goals and all these lies we tell ourselves because we feel so bad about what we did when the issue is not the food. The food is not what's holding you back. It's the anxiety you put about the situation. Why do you think you go so hard on the weekend? It's because you feel like in your head, oh, I have to get these cravings out of my system. I'm never gonna get to have them again. Like, I'm gonna get back on track on Monday and I have to eat what I want right now because I can't have it during the week. When in reality, if you had, like, I don't know, whatever you crave on the weekend, like, I don't know, a glass of wine or Doritos or something. For me, Doritos was like my go-to snack for a long time. Like, once I started letting myself have a little bit of that stuff every day, even if it wasn't healthy or like super good for dieting, I let that stuff be less rare to me and I didn't make so many rules for myself during the week. So, like, I don't know. I feel like the problem is the restriction. I feel like what makes people have such bad feelings about food, and I feel like there's more research that's coming out about this, about like diet culture and how constant restriction and constant like putting a bunch of numbers with food and micromanaging your intake is just proving to just be so like destructive and not good for people who want to actually lose weight and maintain weight loss. So the hardest times that I've ever had dieting and had the hardest time getting success was when I micromanaged my food, when I felt bad about eating certain things, when I beat myself up for eating certain things, when I tried really hard to have a super strict, restricted diet. Those times in my life were the times that I hated myself the most. They were the times that I had the hardest time getting weight off, and that I had the biggest fluctuations where every Friday I got to one weight, but then by the end of the weekend I was 6 or 7 pounds up because I had such a bad mindset about food, and I had this big gap between good eating and bad eating, and weekends were for bad eating, and the weekday was for good eating. And it wasn't until I started getting rid of that extreme to where what I eat on a Monday could very well be what I eat on a Saturday, maybe just in smaller quantities. It's when I started doing that I started, I don't know, not feeling bad about food, not putting food into categories like my weekday food and my weekend food. Like, if you are feeling the need to eat so unhealthy or in such large quantities on the weekend, dude, something's wrong with your weekday diet. Like, if you don't like your weekday diet to the point where like you go so hard with food on the weekend, then change your weekday diet. That's what I did. Like, I stopped tracking macros. I stopped, I still kind of track calories to some degree, but like very loosely, only to really keep myself accountable to some degree. But I don't, like, if I want to eat a Hershey's bar during the week, I just eat one. Like, if I want to have chips and guac, I just have it. Like, all these boundaries between what I can have on the weekdays and what I can have on the weekends, or even like what's good food and bad food, because so many people are like, I just shouldn't be eating bad food ever. Like, I should just be tracking my macros perfectly, eating perfectly healthy so I can like reach my fitness goals. Like, oh my gosh, it's this pressure and this stress that we put on ourselves that are killing us. Like, in the last 2 months, I've dropped about 10 pounds, and it has been the easiest weight loss I've ever had to where I don't even feel like I'm dieting because I have removed all stress and pressure around food. I don't let myself feel anxious if I overeat. I don't feel bad when I overeat at all. I don't feel anxious. I don't feel scared that I'm losing progress. I don't have negative emotions around food, and because of that, I don't have pressure around food so that when the weekend comes, I don't feel pressured to overeat. I don't feel anxiety, like, oh, I'm never gonna get this food again. Like, I have to eat it now or I'm gonna lose out. Like, I don't wanna miss out on this food. Like, food is not rare to me anymore because I can have whatever I want whenever I want. I choose to eat healthier most of the time because I wanna be healthy and I have weight loss goals, but I don't have hard and fast rules for myself. I don't say you're gonna miss out on any event. I don't ever miss out on any events with food. Like, if there's food in an event, I eat it if I want it, you know? But I feel like the issue, again, I feel like I'm repeating myself, but the issue is in not in the food that we're eating, it's in how we perceive this food, how we perceive ourselves, and the pressure that we put on ourselves to be super healthy and super fit. And I don't know, I guess just if I were to give advice on, like, if you're someone who's like this, I would just say, you know, make your lifestyle something you can actually live with. If you have this fitness goal that what it requires from you is so extreme and it just makes you feel so restricted, then change your goal. Like, I was the same way. I had an extreme fitness goal where I wanted to look very, very lean and cut and tiny all the time. And when I realized what that was going to require from me, meaning like, okay, you just can't eat out, or you can't have untracked meals, or you have to track every single macro, I decided, you know what? That behavior makes me miserable. That behavior makes me feel really disordered around food and really anxious around food. So, like, you know, I don't know if you've ever heard of the term reverse engineer your life, but think about your life and what you want it to look like and make sure that none of that conflicts. Because I get clients who are like, I want to be super lean and shredded, but also I want balance. I want to be able to eat what I want and not have rules around my food. Well, guess what? Not everybody can have both. I can't have both. I can't be super duper lean and shredded and also have the balance that I've created with food now. It's not possible. I'd have to be so restricted in my calorie intake and so restricted in the foods that I eat in order to look like that. And for me, I've decided that's not worth it. You guys, I've been a bikini competitor. I have been super duper lean and shredded and had abs like crazy and lost all my cellulite and was like banging. And I was miserable because I was so like restricted. Everything in my whole world revolved around food. It made me miserable because we're not supposed to have that kind of relationship with food. We're not supposed to be micromanaging our food for long periods of time and cutting whole foods out that we want to eat and we want to enjoy. Like, that's not healthy. That's not good for us, you know? So think about the life that you want. Is it a life of balance? Is it a life where you get to enjoy good food once in a while? Is it a life where you don't feel anxious around food and you don't feel restricted, or like you can never eat what you want and all that kind of stuff? If that's the life that you want, you have to work backwards and figure out, how am I going to get there? What am I going to have to do with my food habits to make sure that I don't feel anxiety around food? What am I going to have to do to make sure I don't constantly feel these urges to overeat? What's causing that? Is it because you're feeling restricted? Is it because you're just really genuinely hungry all the time? Is it because you're working out so much you have a huge appetite? Is it because you're a stress eater or an emotional eater? Like, figure out why that's happening and then do something about it. I just tweeted this morning and it's been rolling around in my head all day, but like, life is too short to complain about the stuff that you can change. If you're in a situation right now where you feel this stress and anxiety about food, and you know in your heart that it's a little bit more than what I'm just recommending, like, you know, don't have guilt about food, choose to not see food that way, and like, live your life a little more freely. If you know it's more than that, then get freaking help, dude. Like, that's what I did back in 2014. Yeah, 2014, I went to a therapist over anxiety and food eating anxiety, stuff like that, because I needed help. And I realized, you know what? This is not worth me being miserable about. This is not worth me just like feeling sorry for myself or trying to self-medicate or self-help in some weird way. Like, if you think you might have an eating disorder, if you think you might have anxieties related to food that you can't handle yourself, go get help. Please do not waste the rest of your life or the next 5 years or 10 years or 2 years or even 1 year feeling anxious about this. You do not have to feel anxious about this one more single day if you go do something about it, you know? Like, whether it's talk to some professional or talk to somebody who can help you with this or whatever, but, you know, like, do something. If what you're doing right now is not working for you, do something else. If you're living this cycle, you're in this cycle of just being miserable about what you eat and feeling bad on the weekends and then feeling guilty when Monday comes and then you want to eat everything inside and you're binge eating and you're feeling restricted, like, do something to get out of this. Recognize that your mental health is so much more important than your physical appearance. Especially recognize if the physical body you're going for is not healthy and not a body that your body naturally wants to have. My body naturally did not want to have Lynette on bikini prep. My body did not like that. Some people is fine. Like, I have clients who, like, they can get pretty lean and their body doesn't fight them on it. It doesn't cause stress for them. I wish I was you, dude, but I'm not you. My body likes to be a little bit curvier. My body is happiest and my hormones are most balanced when I'm not necessarily super duper lean, but that's what runs the show for me. I don't choose personally, like, well, I want to look like this and I'm going to do whatever it takes to get there. No. Find what your body's happy point is and do your best mentally to transform your mind to where you're okay with being within that range. You know what I mean? Now this is like turning into a different message, but like I have clients who are moms who like have stretch marks on their belly or have loose skin or whatever. Or I have people like me who just like naturally are not built very lean or tiny or petite. And you can either be super stressed about that and continue to wreck your mind trying to restrict your diet and be super duper on point with your food and whatever and not live your normal life with like food freedom. And you can either live that life in order to have this body that you think is gonna make you happy, which, like, spoiler alert, it does not make you happy. I'm so much happier now that I've decided to take care of my mental health and my hormonal health as opposed to look a certain way. Like, oh my gosh, night and day difference in my happiness level. But you can either do that or you can recognize this is the body I have. This is as good as I can really make it reasonably without cutting off like half of the food in the world, without cutting off going out with people, going to events, stuff like that. Learn to be okay with this. This body, you guys, this is like, I'm not gonna look like this in 2 years. I'm not gonna look like this in 5 years, in 10 years, after I have kids. And guess what it's gonna mean about my life? Literally nothing. My husband's not gonna leave me. People on social media are not gonna like me more. I'm not gonna have more respect if I have four abs versus two abs versus none abs. Like, people don't care. Your impact is not based on what you look like in that specific of an arena. I'm not gonna lie to you and say that by being a young, privileged white person who is attractive, I'm not gonna tell you that this doesn't afford some benefits for me in my life. I'm not an idiot. But the difference between this Lynette versus a Lynette that's like 20 pounds lighter, there's not a difference there. There's in my impact and what I can do in this world, that there's no difference between this Lynette and that Lynette. So why bother putting myself through the stress of being this Lynette when this Lynette can do everything that this Lynette can do, but more? I can be happy and balanced and have children and be like not restricted. I can go out on the weekends with my husband and not flip out or not have this pressure to feel like I have to either starve myself or binge eat because I don't have any normal balance in my life. Like, I always say to my clients, find the middle. Don't restrict, don't binge. Find yourself in the middle where you can enjoy your food, you can enjoy your life. Find a healthy lifestyle that makes you happy, not the one that you have to do in order to get somewhere with your physique. Find the middle. Find the middle ground. Keep searching for it every weekend when you feel like you fail yourself again. Like, just try not feeling guilty about what you ate this week and try not letting yourself think like, oh man, I really blew it. Try not feeling like you're behind. You're not behind anyone. Like, who are you in line? Who are you in line with that you're behind? You know, nobody. This is your journey, and you're allowed to take as long as you want. And if it takes you an extra week because this past weekend didn't go so well, what is an extra week or two or month or 6 months in the whole span of your life? Like, go back to enjoying this. Go back to letting healthy be fun for you and be motivated by that as opposed to just, I have to have abs or I'm not gonna get sponsored by PE Science or something. I don't know, guys. It's not that deep. And maybe this is because I'm older. I mean, I'm not that old, but I am 26. I'm gonna be 27 this year. And my mindset was totally different when I was like 22, 23, 24. So, like, I feel you if you're that age and you're like, Lynette, I can't relate. My life will be better when I'm leaner. Like, I just promise you, it's not gonna be better. If you honestly in your mind believe like my life is gonna be so much better when I'm leaner, ooh girl, I can tell you, it's not if you have to sacrifice your mental health and your ability to be free with food and have food freedom, it's not gonna be better. It's not gonna freaking be better. So I feel like there's so much more that I could have said in this video, and but you know, it's like 20 minutes long and I really don't wanna like keep y'all here all day. See if I like got anything off my list. I think we're good. Yeah, I hope that this helped somebody and wasn't just like super weird or offensive or, yeah, I just spoke my heart. So, thank you guys so much for watching. If you made it to this ending, if you did make it to an ending, to this ending, leave in the comments below the word cowboy. Because the cowboy emoji is my favorite emoji, by the way. The like dude with like the little cowboy hat. He's like, I don't know. Okay, I love you guys. Bye!